Hey, hey peeps, welcome back. So, I got my banana tree out and he's bananas, or going bananas. So, I've only showed you to him once before in my full house tour video. But he's not the first banana tree I've had. I actually had another one for quite some years that I raised from a pup that was given to me. And it got huge. It got really, really huge. Like, I think it was about 4 feet tall when I had to give it away because we needed to make some space. But seeing as things didn't work out for the reason we needed the space, I thought, well, hell with it, let's grow another one. So I traded my big one for two babies. And what happened was one of those babies was just so sick and too far gone, it just died on me. And the other one was growing a pup, which was this one. And luckily, it was already established enough, because what had happened was my husband, love him, he got a drone. And he was playing about with it and flying the drone, and he crashed it, and he crashed it into my banana tree. He was really not happy, believe me, because he completely mangled it with the propellers, and it was just completely devastated. It just died back. But the pup was strong enough to survive, so I led it on the little stump where the old tree was dying off, and when it rotted enough and the pup had I think it had a few roots of its own, about three or four roots at that point, I just kind of pulled it apart, took the risk, and replanted this guy, and this is what grew. And he was probably about 3 or 4 centimeters, not probably, about, I would say about 6 centimeters, give or take, when I first got him. And he was attached to the mother, so he's grown quite a lot. And I did take another video when he was a lot smaller, and I'll try and insert a clip in so you can see just how big he's grown. I mean, obviously I had him for a while at that point. I think it was a couple of months, so he'd already done a little bit of growing, but you get the idea. And then if you look back on my house tour, you can actually see how much he's grown from there. So yeah, I thought what I'm going to do first is, one, you can see how big he's grown since the last time, like I said, but two, he's actually growing. Yes, that's right, you can see there's a pup here. Well, not just a pup, there's another one here. You can see that little green thing there, that's the beginnings of another one, and he's not done yet. Where is it? Nice. Where I saw third one somewhere. Hang on, sorry guys, bear with me a minute. So that's number two. Number three. Ah, there he is. There he is. Right, so that's one over there, two there, and number three, you can see, just happened to peek up through the soil there. Let's just clear that off so he can grow a bit. There we go. Just clear the top a bit. So it's got three babies growing now, which is cool. So this one is a baby maker. Now, the strange thing with my last one was it never really gave off babies. It just grew huge. And I'll try and insert a picture in at some point, if I can find one. If not, I'll try and get a video of it at some point next time I visit my friend, because this tree is bananas. It's almost about 7 years old now, and I think it's close to about 6 foot with the pot, so it's huge. So I'll try and show that to you at some point if I can't find any pictures that I have of it. So yeah, that's three perps and all this growth. I mean, you can see here, this is where it was a couple of months ago, and then it kind of had a growth spurt here. It's given off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 leaves in the last I'd say about 2 months, give or take. So it's really shot up and started growing, which is why I moved it outside. So while I'm at it, I think I'll give you some care instructions as well, because yeah, why not, for the spirit of learning and loving and growing. And a little bit of a caution though. You see this here, this is burn damage. Now, I made a little bit of a mistake and put him in a spot where he gets a little bit of direct sunlight, and it had rained, and the rain was on the leaves, and obviously when the sun came out, this is what happened. It burnt it, so it looks a bit ugly. And when it does this, you know, this is just a combination of water damage and a little bit of dehydration. But for the most part, these new leaves here, they're all healthy and happy, and they didn't get any sunburn damage. So, okay, watering instructions. Now, banana trees, they are tropical plants, so in the rainforest, they get a lot of humid and moist conditions. They're rained on almost every day. They get a lot of warmth, but I think they get shaded light, like they're kind of under other canopies kind of thing, because even though they're tropical, and you would expect, because banana trees get big, they can take direct sunlight, they can't. So they like bright indirect sunlight, lots of it, a lot of warmth, and they like to be kept moist, right? Not soaking wet, because the roots don't like to to sit in water, so it really doesn't like to have wet feet. So when you repot it, it's good to put like gravel or some aqua pebbles or something like that at the bottom, so it creates a bit of an additional drainage and the roots don't sit in water when it does drain to the bottom. And so the soil needs to be very well draining. The roots need to be away from sitting and standing water, and the soil needs to be kept good and moist, and not let to sit dry for more than a couple of days, because then you really start to see like shriveling at the end of the leaves. This is burn damage, but it kind of looks similar. You'll see like drying tips here. This is starting to turn black where it sat, and here where it was dry. Normally if it's got enough water, it would be with a tip like this, and it would be very moist, almost with like a droplet of water hanging on the end here, like this one. But this is a bit dry because I let it sit dry for a little too long. So yeah, keep it moist, don't let it sit too dry. Give it plenty of light, but not direct sunlight. Keep water off the leaves to avoid burn damage. And yeah, in the winter when it starts to get cold and freezing, bring this guy indoors, because it has zero tolerance for cold weather. So in the spring and the summer when it's nice and warm, put him outside. He's gonna love it, he's gonna thrive. He'll grow fast, yeah, on average about one of these leaves a week or so, give or take. But in the colder months, obviously bring him in, otherwise yeah, he's gonna die. As for fruit, I don't know. I know you can get some ornamental types and dwarf types that will never produce fruit, or if they do, it will kind of be bitter and unrecognizable as a banana, and you wouldn't want to eat it. Or they will grow to giants and eventually produce fruit. But obviously, because if you're growing it in a house, that again, they're not going to be the tastiest. But the downside is once it does flower, a banana tree will actually die, which is why it reproduces the pups so readily. They're essentially baby makers, so you're going to get a lot of banana trees if it's happy. For it to flower and fruit can take, I think, about 6 to 8 years. So yeah, you're in for the long haul with these guys. But they're very easy, they're very fast growing, and as long as you give them what they want, they're quite undemanding. So yeah, that's some basic care and an update on my banana tree. And I'll try and get some inserts put in here when I do the editing, so you can have a look. If not, sorry, and I'll try and get a separate video of my old banana tree in its new home. Anyway, peeps, thanks for watching. As always, it's much appreciated. Much love, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.